Listen, if you use Cash App to ask people for money, or if you use Cash App to send money, you need to be using Cash App to invest.
Yeah, yo. Yeah, yo. Moon la la. Yeah, yo. Bitch better have my money. Y'all should know me well enough. Bitch better have my money.
What's up, wealth babes? I am back with another long-awaited and overdue video. I'm laughing because it's been so long. I feel like it's been a whole half a year, if not more. But I can't get into why I've been gone for so long. I mean, if you're interested in hearing about that, comment below and say, I want to know where you've been, Shay. But this video today is about investing in 3 easy steps. So let's go ahead and get into that video. But before we do, make sure you hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Be sure to thumbs up this video if you want to see more from me. And leave a hashtag wealthbabe in the comments below if you're a part of the community. So let's go ahead and get right into it. Quick overview I do want to share is that I know a lot of you all probably feel like investing is risky, risky business, you're scared, but listen, in my opinion, it's riskier not to invest because the longer you are, the longer you give yourself a chance to be in the market, the wealthier, the higher the chance you have of becoming wealthier. So I need you guys to know that to build wealth, you need to invest. So go ahead and start investing today, ASAP. The thing about it is these apps that we have used and are currently using, but not for investing, and I'll get into what apps those are in a minute, have made it so easy, so much easier to invest today. So in 2020, you can invest with the click of a button. I'm so serious. And so I'll go ahead and get into those apps. Cash App is the first one that I want to talk about. Listen, if you use Cash App to ask people for money, or if you use Cash App to send money, you need to be using Cash App to invest. Cash App has the option for you to buy stocks. Stop playing around and get into the stock market ASAP. The other app, which I'm not going to expand too much on in this video right now, is Stockpile. And I'll make another video in the future. Well, let me know if you guys are interested in learning more about Stockpile, but I'm not going to focus on Stockpile too much in this video. However, Stockpile is another one that has made it easy to invest. The good thing about Cash App, yo, it is free. You can invest at no cost. Just put your money into the market and become wealthy. So let's go ahead and talk about how easy it is to invest in Cash App in 3 easy steps. Step 1, you probably can already skip this app because I can bet my bottom dollar that 99% of the Black community got Cash App, especially if you live in a DMV. So step 1 was going to be sign up for the app. Sign up, get you a Cash App, and if you already got Cash App, you can go ahead and skip this step. Step 2 is to go ahead and click this little, it's a squiggly line. It kind of looks like a parabola graph. It looks like a graph. When you can't miss it. When you go into Cash App, once you've signed up, or if you already have the app, once you go into it, click on the thing that has the squiggly line, and that will take you to the stocks and bitcoins portion of Cash App. And all you need to do is search up the stock that you would like to buy. Just search it up. Click the graph and search in the search bar the stock that you're interested in purchasing. Step 3, this is pretty much where the magic happens. And if you have never invested and you're about to do this, I'm sorry if y'all can hear the house phone ringing. Let me give it a second. All right, so I'm back. The house phone stopped ringing. We might as well get rid of the house phone. We don't need it. But anyway, so step three is where the magic happens. Once you click and search the stock that you're interested in purchasing, the magic happens here. All you need to do is click buy. Like click buy, and all you need to do from there is type in the amount you want to spend, put into that stock, put into that company, and then click confirm. It's not hard at all. Like, you won't be able to mess it up. You can't mess this up. So go ahead, download Cash App, search the stock that you want from the graph section of the app, click buy once you get there, and then okay and confirm. That's as easy as it is, and it's not hard at all. You can't mess it up. If this is your first time purchasing a stock, you will be extremely, 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 extremely proud of yourself. So I want to go ahead and commend you if you have Cash App and if you are already investing. If not, and you watch this video and you start investing, I want to commend you too. Like, listen, it's so easy to invest these days. Go ahead and get in the market. I want to do a challenge for the month of January. So by the time you guys see this video, it'll be January 6th. Let's go ahead and do a 30-day challenge. I feel like this challenge will help us to at least navigate the waters if we're new to investing and figure it out. You don't have to put a lot of money. If you're scared and you don't know what's going on or what you're getting yourself into, invest a dollar. Just invest a dollar and watch how that dollar changes over time, over the course of these 30 days. So pretty much the details of the challenge is to maybe invest $1 over the 30-day period if you're not scared. So all you need is $30, and each day I want you to go ahead and invest into whatever stocks you're interested in. The caveat here is that the stock market does close at 4:30 p.m. on the weekdays. So when you go to click buy, sometimes it doesn't purchase the stock right away. And also the stock market is closed on the weekends. So if you are going to invest over this 30-day period, and you're going to definitely skip the weekends because the stock market is closed, so you won't be able to purchase, but you can go ahead and schedule that purchase, or just do $2 or $3 at a time the following week, or the following day, once the weekend is over. You guys get what I'm saying. But anyway, so a dollar, if you are really new, you want to get your feet wet and you're not scared, go ahead and put away $30 to invest. And if you are on the, like, oh, I'm ready, sis, let's get into it, I would say invest $5 a day. So you'll just need to set $150 aside and know that that $150 is going to go towards you investing in the stock market. So yeah, I'll say just sit aside $30 through $150, take that money and invest over this 30-day period. I think, if I'm not mistaken, if we start on January 6th, our end date is going to be February 4th. So yes, invest that money. Is 2020, so we're only going up from here. If you find that you can't come up with $30, I already know what you're doing with your money without even looking at your bank statements. So I'm gonna tell you to go ahead and sacrifice the fast food for the month of January. It's a new year. So let's do something different to become the people or the person that we want to become. Set aside money so that you can invest. I don't want to hear that you don't have the money. You can make a sacrifice. Sacrifice 2 visits to the mall per month. I don't know, a pair of shoes, fast food. Sacrifice something so that you can invest and get this money in the stock market so that you can see it grow. Okay, so comment below and let me know what company you've invested in, because this wraps this video up and you guys definitely will be seeing more of me in 2020. So yeah, comment below and let me know what company you've invested in or which companies you've invested in, because I know some of y'all gonna go hard and invest in more than one company. And actually, to be quite frank, it's smarter to diversify. So in other words, don't put all of your eggs in one basket. I believe experience is the best teacher, so just go ahead and get into the stock market if you're scared, if you're on the side of fear. Like I said earlier, just invest a dollar over this 30 days and let's see how that dollar does. And I can bet you any amount of money you will want to invest more. Experience is the best teacher. So that is it for now, Wealth Babes. I will be seeing you in 2020. And just remember that if you're not truly, fully committed to building wealth, then the chances are you won't. Mwah.